probability testing. What is probability? So, a normal distribution, recurrence Sakit actually told you yesterday, was like this. And what is a normal distribution? Usually, what things are normally distributed? Which things? Huh? Now, what variables are usually normally distributed? What variables? What is a variable? Age is variable, sex is variable, serum cholesterol level is variable, right? How many of you know your height and weight? Everybody knows their height and weight?
Yes.
Okay? Let's do this exercise. So, what is the, let's start with you. What is your weight?
Weight.
Actual weight, true weight. 110. 110? Yes. 110 kg? Okay, you?
Me?
Uh-huh.
80.
80?
Yeah. That's okay.
Sir?
58.
Anyone else? You?
75.
Somewhere there, huh? Doctor. Okay, let's start.
64.
Huh? 64. 64?
Yeah. Make it random sample.
If I take all the weights, there will be something like that. Not exactly, okay? But if I make all the weights, it will be actually something like. So there will be few people who are very, very, you know, heavy, like 110 and above. Very few people who will be like, no. So most of you will be, most of you will be number. You agree or not agree?
Yeah.
And I can show you the graph which is from our own data which we are using, okay? This is, this is the data or the weight of the patients who are included in the data which I gave you. Okay? And these are real weights because we measured them. They both were in women together. We did not separate them. And it's not exactly normally distributed, but it's like few here, maybe a little bit above here, but most of them are in the middle. Okay? And if you fix a curve here, it looks like that. If it were a normal distribution, it will go like this. So maybe you are missing some here, maybe an extra here. But that's not too different. If you have thousands and thousands of people, you will have a very smooth normal curve. Birth weight, body weight, height, serum cholesterol, you know, all biological variables among healthy people, not the sick people, they usually follow a normal distribution. That's it. Some of the skewed distribution which you were showed, I think, day before yesterday, is that, for example, income is a skewed. It's usually, you know, very few people who have very, very high income. Okay? But the rest of them are on that side. That's it. Okay? So that's why normal distribution is important, and we'll introduce this to you to explain what is the probability. So, the first question which I would like you to consider the heights of adult women is the same. Basically, you know, they will follow a bell-shaped curve. Okay, but that means that most of the women will be in the middle, very few short women, very few, very, very tall women. Okay. Against a biological women. Second question I would like you to consider, what does it mean to say that a 3-year-old child's weight is in the 30th percentile? for all 3-year-old children in the network question. You should be able to answer this question because you are all medical doctors. Can you answer this question? What does it mean? How many of you have seen a growth chart? You have seen a growth chart? Only one?
Yes,
sir. Anybody
else? Yes, from third percentile to
95%. Okay, from third percentile to?
95%
to 97%. Okay, let's see, this is a growth chart. These are normal. This is age, yeah? This is weight. And this is the normal, whatever, you know, something like that. So this line is the third percentile. This line is 97% or 95%?
97,
yeah. Okay. So basically, you know, everybody in the middle, so what they are telling you, if somebody falls below it, somebody falls above it, what is wrong?
Up the range. Out
of range. Yeah, so you have a child who is here, you should be concerned this child is underweight, right?
Yes.
So this basically depends on, you know, they took weights of thousand and thousand normal children and they developed this graph. Okay? So they say, okay, most of the people are like in the normal range in this. But this person, this baby is very, very, you know, light. I mean, his weight is not according to be. So you should take extra care. This is a bit, you know. Where is the 38% here? You can imagine, can somebody tell me? Let's say this is the line, this is 1-year-old, 3-year-old child.
Yeah.
On this line, where is the child?
Somewhere
here, huh? Normal, but okay, so this is 38%. Suppose if I ask you the same question on the normal distribution, can you tell me if this is the mean? Mean, okay. You know what is the median? You did median yesterday. In a normal curve, mean and median are the same place.
Yes.
Exactly the same, okay? So this mean is also the 50th percentile. So where will the child be?
At
38%?
At 1.5.
Somewhere here, huh?
Yes.
Maybe, okay? So this is the idea which we would like to explore further. Yeah.
Can we say that this is 1.5 or 1.2 standard deviation?
Yeah, we can do that. Okay. This is the mean, is the average standard deviation you learned yesterday. So the mean and mode median are the central tendency, and the standard deviation is a measure of the spread.
Okay.
That's simple. Okay. So standardized school is the number of standard deviation an individual falls above or below the mean. And they could be positive or negative, right?
Yeah.
And we'll show it inshallah right now. So let's see that example is males in these ages have a mean height of 70 inches, standard deviation is 2.8 inches. Female in the same age group, mean height is 65 inches and standard deviation is 2.5 inches. There's a mean who is 72, there's a man, sorry, who is 72.8 inches tall, has a standard deviation score of 1. Why? The mean is 70,
yeah.
Standard deviation is
2.8.
70 plus 2.8, 72.8 is exactly 1 standard deviation above. Okay? And all of these data sets, as I told you, length of bones, and they tend to be, you know, following normal distribution pattern.
The previous example, how can we know that it is exactly one standard deviation?
Yeah, we'll tell you. Just wait one more minute. Okay? So, describe the shape of a histogram. This is a histogram, for example. And again, as I said, if you had thousands and thousands of information, observations, you will have this type of curve. Since you don't have thousands and thousands, you know, you get histogram which is somewhat like, not exactly, but you know. And forget this thing, but actually, you know, maybe you can come back to it later. Okay? This is what I showed you. This is the real data from our sample practice data. And it actually seems to be following a normal curve, although this thing is lighter, no? Because the line is going here, these people are heavier than they should be. But then there are diabetics and there are obese people also. So this is how it works. This is the asymmetric with positive skewness, and this is the mean and the standard deviation idea. So if this is one standard deviation and this is the mean, and here is plus one standard deviation. If you take it there, it will be minus one standard deviation. So what proportion of individuals will fall into any range of values and at any given percentile? So this is actually, just to remember that this is the symbol for mean. X, we call it X bar. It's actually not X, but it should be X bar. And this standard deviation is, sometimes it's say SB, sometimes it's simply S, okay? What are these things? Any idea?
This is this,
Okay, this is the sample. You could look a sample, you calculate a mean, okay? For example, there are 1 billion children in a scene, okay? Out of them, you took a sample of 100 children, okay? Random sample. The mean of those, weight of those children is X bar. The standard deviation is S or SD, okay?
The approximate.
Yeah. If this, if you go to all, collect all the 1 million children, and take a mean of that, that is called the population mean, okay? That is represented by the mu. This is a Greek letter mu, it's a population mean. So what are we after is this. We're not interested in those 100 children. We are interested in the 1 million children, right? So, this is an estimate of this. Now, this X bar is not exactly the same as mu, but it will be close.
Estimate of
more or less close. Huh? Similarly, the letter sigma, a small sigma, in the Greek letter is used for the standard deviation in the population. Okay, so in the empirical rules are this, that 68% of the data will be between mean plus minus 1 ST, okay? 95% will be between mean plus minus 2 ST, 99.7% will be, okay, between 3, plus minus 3 STs. It's actually they are using the population values. But this has been told, Dr. Sakit had discussed this yesterday, okay? So, just remember that plus minus 4 ST will be maybe 99.9%. It can never be 100%. Just remember that, okay? But it will always be above. But it will be very close, okay? So the empirical rule is 68% of the values fall within one standard deviation plus minus. 95% within 2 standard deviations, 99.7% within 3 standard deviations of the mean. Okay? That's the rule, 68, 95, 99.7. And I would like you to remember because it's something which you can use. Okay, this is how it shows, 68% plus minus 1 SD. And the only thing I would like to emphasize is that this curve, wherever you take, it will always be above the line, you will never touch the line. So that you never can capture one. Questions? No? So, now to coming to your question, how you actually find out somebody's below or above? This is the Haines study, which is, I think, the US study, very old data, but they're telling you, okay. Now, suppose this is the, something which I first told you, that the mean is 70 and the standard deviation is 2.8, okay? So, what proportion of men are less than 72.1 inches tall? Can you tell me?
You subtract 60, not 60, yeah.
68, no, 68, minus 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, 60, Because me and so what is what? How many people are here in this?
25. 25%.
84.
35. Why did you say 84?
Because
plus minus 2 standard deviation is 68% in the middle. Plus minus standard deviation will be 34%, half of that, right? So this is up to here is 50. This is 34. Total 84. And how many are above? How many are taller than 72.8? 16% off. Okay. So let's see. And this is what you how you do it. Between the two lines is 68%. And below that, you know, minus one standard deviation is 16%. 68% plus 16% is 84%. Right? Same way as you can do. Okay. Then you have what proportion of men are less than 68 inches tall? Can you say that the standard deviation is 2.8, mean is 70. How many will be less than 68 inches tall?
60.
How do you calculate it? It's not an exact standard deviation. It's standard deviation is 2.8. Okay. This is mean minus 2. Okay. Mean minus 2.8 will be 16%, right? But this is 2, not 2.8.
So the mean is 70?
Yes.
70.
This is how you do it actually. How many centimeters is 68 from 70? Is basically observed value minus mean divided by standard deviation, okay? 68 minus 70 divided by 2.8 is 0.71. So if it were 2.8, if it were like 67.2, it would be 2.8 standard deviation, it would be exactly 1 standard deviation away. But it, since this is 2, you know, 68 minus 70 is 2, divided by 2.8 is 0.71. 0.71 standard deviation on that side. Okay? So how you calculate the value of 68 is 0.71 standard deviation is below the mean, which is 70. So this is what we call a standardized score. Z is a standardized score, X is the observed value, mu is the population mean, sigma is the population standard deviation, and this is the formula. Okay? And you can switch it to, you know, you can switch this to X bar, you can switch this to S also. This value is called a Z or a Z, okay? And Z is basically is from normal distribution. What does it do, okay? Basically, what proportion of males are less than 68 inches tall, you apply this formula. 0.7 is standard values, okay? You go to the standard normal table, which is in most textbooks have it, the websites have it actually, and they call the Z distribution table the standard normal tables, okay? Look up the closest standard value score in the table and find the percentile corresponding to the standardized score. Just like the way you did it roughly, that the child and the 30th percentile will lie somewhere over there. But this is more accurate, okay? You will check the table. This is called a Z value. And this is how it works. So for example, this is an example of a table, the Z score which you calculate from there. So you have 0.7 here, okay? Your standardized score is 0.7. It's a standard deviation, but you call it as Z score because you calculated it using that formula. So it will be in a 24.20 percentile. That's the
point, okay? There is no other way you can estimate it roughly.
Roughly you can. I mean, if you go back here, you say that, suppose, if it was here, it would be 16%, but it's here, so it's a little more than 16%, it's about 22%, okay? But for exactly, you have to make the formula, and the formula is telling you about 24.20%.